Hello everyone, welcome back to my channel. In this video, you will see how to separate precious metals such as gold and silver from the rest of the metals. In a traditional way, I got this piece from some friends, and it is a result he obtained after melting metal stones. After observing it, it became clear to me that it contains several metals grouped together, which is indeed very heavy. When an item is heavy, we first suspect that it contains iron. To find out, we will use a strong magnet. Here I will set the weight for this piece. Please like and subscribe to my channel. And don't forget to click on the bell icon to get new video updates. The melting process is a phase transition, in which a substance changes from a solid to a liquid state due to an increase in temperature. As heat is added to the solid, its particles gain energy and start moving more rapidly, eventually breaking the bonds that hold them in a fixed, ordered arrangement. This results in the substance transitioning into a liquid state, where the particles are more disordered and able to flow past one another. The temperature at which melting occurs is known as the melting point, and it is a characteristic property of each substance. We will use an ancient method to ensure that the piece contains gold, silver, or other precious metals without resorting to the current chemical method. When we are completely certain of the presence of the precious metal, there will be another stage, perhaps mostly chemical. The process of smelting combined metals requires more effort and takes a long time. That's why I will get back to you shortly. As you will notice, there are precious metals such as gold, silver, and copper, and some impurities, and perhaps there is lead. The fact that lead is one of the problems that must be addressed in another way. Fortunately, this piece contains only a small portion of lead. The processes for separating lead from gold and silver require the use of specific chemical or physical techniques such as flotation, electrolytic refining, or extraction using chemical agents. These techniques rely on the chemical and physical properties of the elements. But as you can see, this piece is extracted from stones and contains gold, silver, copper, and lead, so it can be clearly seen with the naked eye. Here I see gold, silver, copper, and lead well, but first, lead must be separated from other metals, and this requires other skill, such as dissolving it in cement or bone. Then, secondly, using chemistry to separate silver and copper from gold. Therefore, wait for us in a new video to find out a good way to do this. Please like and subscribe to my channel, and don't forget to click on the bell icon to get new video updates. Thanks for watching. Don't forget to like and subscribe my channel for more videos.